Lamborghini's first SUV, the unmistakably 1980s LM002, was a military-grade brute powered by a screaming V12 engine. While it seemed completely offbeat at the time, it turned out to be prescient given today's ever-expanding array of ultra-luxury, high-performance SUVs from the likes of Bentley, Mercedes-Benz, Porsche, Maserati, and, soon, Ferrari and Aston Martin. So there's no time like the present for Lamborghini to jump back into the fray with the 2019 Urus. The company's second-ever SUV is over the top, too, but for completely different reasons than the LM002. The Urus, which derives its name from an ancient species of cattle, stuns with its 641 horsepower, its dramatic wedge-shaped silhouette, and its ambition to be as capable around a racetrack as it is on the sand dunes. Under the hood is the first turbocharged engine ever to be installed in a Lamborghini, and the first V8 in many decades. It shares its 4.0-liter displacement with the twin-turbocharged V8 installed in many other Volkswagen Group products, but Lamborghini insists that the design is its own, a claim augmented by the V8's distinctive sound. Output sits at 641 horsepower and 627 pounds-to-foot of torque, second only to the decidedly lower rent, 707 horsepower Jeep Grand Cherokee Trackhawk in the sport arena. The Urus also will eventually be home to Lamborghini's first hybrid drivetrain, although we don't yet know any details about the gas-electric model. The underpinnings of the Urus aren't as distinctly Italian, as it shares the Volkswagen Group's MLB platform used in the Audi Q7, the Porsche Cayenne, and the Bentley Bentayga. Lamborghini assures us, though, that the Urus will outperform each of those corporate cousins, with a claimed top speed of 190 miles per hour, 3 miles per hour higher than the Bentayga, and a reported 0 to 62 miles per hour time of 3.6 seconds. Of course, the Lamborghini will feature its own chassis tuning, too, and rear-wheel steering and an air suspension are expected to be part of the package. The all-wheel drive system uses a locking center differential with a default 40-60 front-rear power split that can send up to 70% of the torque to the front or up to 87% to the rear. A rear differential allows for torque vectoring capability. The carbon ceramic brakes are absolutely enormous, with 17.3-inch rotors in front and 14.6 in the rear, in order to manage the roughly 4,400-pound curb weight. A lineup of driving modes including Casa, Race, Sabbia, Sand, and Neve, Snow, will diversify the Lambo's skill set. In Casa, for instance, the all-wheel drive system routes more power to the rear, and the torque vectoring and stability control thresholds allow for a bit more slip. In Sabbia, the stability control is similarly recalibrated to accommodate the low grip surface. Good luck off-roading, though, with the Urus's available 23-inch wheels mounted on unique Pirelli summer tires. 21 and 22-inchers will be available, too, as will all-season options. When it goes on sale in the United States late next year, the Urus will share space at the entry-level end of the Lamborghini lineup with the Huracán, as it's expected to start at roughly the same $200,000 as that V10 supercar. A vast expansion of Lamborghini's factory in its hometown of Sant’Agata Bolognese, Italy, already has been completed to build the Urus, as the company expects to considerably increase its annual production output with the SUV's addition to its portfolio. After all, among luxury brands, super SUVs are all the rage right now, and this Italian is shaping up to be one of the most super of all.
Phones, Babylon's came.